this your brother, y'all. This your brother, Irene, HOI Las Vegas. We got the brothers, the mighty brothers of Voice of Yahweh with us. And we out here to put this word out, man, to reach them lost sheep, right? But first and foremost, before we get started, like to give our honor and glory to Yahweh by Hashem of Mashiach Yahushai. Like to give a double honors to the elders that paved the way for this. And we can get into it, man. You know, give me the book of Luke, chapter 14, and verse 23. You know, give me a second. Yeah, man. All right. Go ahead and bring that out, King.
This is the book of Luke, chapter 14, verse 23.
Bring it out.
And the Lord said unto the servant, go out into the highways and hedges, and compel them to come in, that my house may be filled.
Right, right. So the Lord commanded us to come out here and to preach and teach our people, wake our people up, man. This is a commandment that was given to us, man. So it's our duty to come out here and to feed the lost sheep, man. Even if they want to hear or not, you know. This word must be put out. It must be put out. Bring that out, King.
This is the book of Zephaniah, chapter 2 and verse 1. And it reads, gather yourselves together. Yea, gather together, O nation not desired. Before the decree bring forth, before the day pass as the chaff, before the fierce anger of the Lord Yahweh come upon you, before the day of the Lord's anger come upon you.
Right. So in these last days, man, it's important for us to gather together, man, because we're stronger in numbers, man. We're stronger together. We hold each other accountable, right? When we going off, man, hey, we give them that love and with that rebuke, man. Right? We rebuke them in love, man. So it's important for us to come together and gather ourselves together, man. Especially in these last days. Because our people, man, as a whole, man, we don't know how to come together, man, to do anything. Right? But you see the other nations, they gather together and they do their thing. And it's all good, man. But our people, we argue, we fight. So it's important for us to come together like the Lord said, man. Another thing, man, I get tired of hearing that the Bible is written by men, man. When the scriptures say otherwise, it tells you that Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, man, he wrote that. Right? Bring that out in Deuteronomy 9.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 9, verse 10. And the Lord delivered unto me 2 tables of stone written with the finger of God.
With the what?
With the finger of God. And on them was written according to all the words which the Lord spake with you in the mount out of the midst of the fire in the day of the assembly.
Right, so long story short, man, the Bible was written by the finger of Yahweh by Hashem Yahushai, man.
That's right.
It was written by Yahweh, man. Right? At the end of the day. So when people say that, oh, the Bible was written by man, they don't know what the hell going on, man. They lost. Right? And then let's get another account.
This is the book of Exodus, chapter 31 and verse 18. And he gave unto Moses, when he had made an end of communing with him upon Mount Sinai, 2 tables of testimony, tables of stone, written with the finger of the Most High.
Right. So at the end of the day, this book that we bring out, man, this word that we're speaking, it was written by Yahweh at the end of the day. So when you hear these damn scoffers, man, these people out here that don't know what the hell going on, man, the Bible is written by Yahweh, man, by the finger of God at the end of the day, man. open that up for me.
This is the book of Luke, chapter 24, verse 44.
Bring it out.
And he said unto them, these are the words which I spake unto you while I was yet with you, that all things must be fulfilled which were written in the law of Moses and in the prophets and in the Psalms concerning me.
Right. Right, so the understanding, the reason why people don't understand the Bible because it's not given to them, right? Only Yahweh Vashim Yahweh Shah can get that to us, right? Can give you that spirit, right? To be able to understand what is being spoken, what you're reading, you know, what's going on in this world, man. All the questions can be answered in the scriptures.
Right?
How you doing, brother? All your questions can be answered through the scriptures, man. All you gotta do is pick up the book and read, man. Right? Give me four. This is the book of Baruch, chapter 4 and verse 1.
No.
This is the book of the commandments of God and the law that endureth forever.
What?
And the law that endureth forever. All they that keep it shall come to life, but such as leave it shall die.
Right. So this book of the law, man, it's going to endure forever, man. No matter what's going on, no matter what happens to this damn, this world we're living in, man, it's gonna keep going. This law, the law ain't done away with, man. Right? We still got law, statutes, and commandments to follow. Right? So it's important for us as individuals, as people of the 12 tribe, man, to continue to strive for this truth, man.
Right.
Continue to push this word. Continue to follow his law, statutes, and commandments, because they weren't just put on here for us. We weren't meant to just sit out here and just live and just do what the hell we want to do, man. It's not set up like that, right? Just like when you go out here into the workplace, man, you got rules and regulations you need to follow. So the same thing, according to the scriptures, man, according to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah, man, we got to follow his lead, man, right? We got to follow these law, statutes, and commandments. So you see these people out here spending on the Sabbath, man, doing what the hell they want to do, man. That's against the law, right? Right. So we're going to go into what happens when you don't, when you're not following the law, man. Matter of fact, go to the This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, and verse 1. And it shall come to pass, if thou wilt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
Right.
Verse 2. And all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee, if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Right. So if you hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, if you're following his law, statutes, and commandments, you're going to be rewarded, man, with blessings, man. Right? But that didn't happen in our case, man, because we went against what was written. We went against. We were stiff-necked, man. We didn't want to listen. So therefore, the Lord punished us, man. And we're still living that out right now. We still in captivity, man. It's not with chains and it's not with chains on our necks like we used back in the day, like our forefathers. But now it's spiritual, man. Right? It's more on the spiritual level now. Also, bring out the person.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou would not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
Right, so all these curses coming upon us and overtaking us, man. Just like I was saying, the hard bondage that we had to live in before, it's different now, man. They gave you a little bit more freedom, but it's still a different form of slavery, man. Right? We still gotta go to them for the one of all things, man. We gotta go to them to go get a bottle of water. If we want something to drink, we gotta go buy it. If we want something to eat, we gotta go buy it. We gotta go buy it from who? Our oppressors. Right? So at the end of the day, we're not free. We're not free. We still in bondage. It's just a different form. Right? Bring that out. Bring out the first curse.
Verse number 16. Cursed shall thy be in the city, and cursed shall thy be in the field.
Cursed shall thy be in the city, man. Anywhere you go on this planet, man, you got a ghetto, man. Where our people are at. Right? We got a hood in every city in America, man. You got a hood in damn in other countries, in London. Right? Everywhere you go, you got our people, we're living in poverty, man. Right? We struggling, man. Those are the curses, man. How you doing, brother? What's your name, brother? What's your name, man? Brian? How you doing, man? How you doing, brother? You know who you are? According to the scriptures? Who are you on this time, brother? Who are you, man? These are the 12 tribes of Israel.
Egypt again with ships.
So we were shipped here in America. America is a modern day Egypt, right? It's not right. Oh, you been here before? You said what? You
good? I said we been here.
Oh, of course. Hell yeah. Yeah. Exactly. See, you been on it, brother. I see you. Here, you're still breathing. It's another day for you to draw closer and closer to the Most High, man. Yeah. You need to start tapping into this, man, and start changing your ways, right? So if you're moving a certain way right now, you need to start changing, man. Start working on yourself day by day. It ain't gonna happen overnight, man. You know.
Deuteronomy 28 and verse 68, and the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships by the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again, and there ye shall be sold unto your enemies for bond men and bond women, and no man shall buy you.
Right. So, just like I was saying earlier, man, that bondage, man, we're still in slavery, man, at the end of the day. It's just a different form now.
It's not within the general sense as it came to be known as by the catastrophic events that took place. So, I look at it more along the lines of mental.
You say what?
I look at it more along the lines of mental slavery.
Mental slavery? You can say that in a sense too, because like the they brainwashed a lot of our people, man. They brainwashed a lot of our people, like with these churches, these different churches, the way they're teaching the Bible, that ain't the way, man. That ain't what Yahweh, that ain't what God was saying. Bring it out.
For he answered and said, I am not sent, but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Right. So he was only sent for the house of Israel. And when you read in the Bible, it's only 12 tribes in Israel.
Which is all they are representing.
Right. So he's not talking about the whole world. When he's talking, look, plain upon table. This Bible ain't for everybody. This for our people only. This for our people. And I'm talking about the 12 tribes. I'm not talking about for, you know what I mean?
I can agree and like this. But it still also says that love for all these people, all these creatures. Now, all of us in San Francisco,
book of Romans, chapter 9, verse 13.
Bring it out.
It is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated.
Right, see? So that's two different nations, man. He didn't love everybody. Like, I understand where you're coming from with the, you know, where everybody stemmed, but they didn't come from this bloodline.
No.
They didn't come from that bloodline. This ain't for them. Right, exactly. This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 14 and verse 2. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God, and the Lord have chosen thee to be a peculiar people unto himself above all the nations that are upon the earth. It's upon the earth, man. So it's all about us, man. Give me Romans 9 and 14. Romans 9 and 4. Like, so this, I hear you, you know what I mean? But you got some digging to do, brother. You got to get in these scriptures and really
get detailed on it. Get, you know what I mean?
No, I didn't. Don't get me wrong. I didn't say that authority.
Oh, okay, okay.
I definitely didn't say okay. that. I was just agreeing with you.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It came off with
okay, okay, all right, all praise, all praise. Yeah, it is. This is the book of Romans, chapter 9 and verse 4. Who are Israelites, to whom pertaineth the adoption, and the glory, and the covenant, and the giving of the law, and the service of God, and the promises.
Right, so he was given the law, the promises, and everything, man. That's why I said, hey, these other nations, they don't have to follow the law, statutes, and commandments. Because it wasn't given to them. So they can go out here and eat shrimp, crab, lobster, and do what the hell they want to do. We can't do that. Hey, all praise. Hey, stay away from it. Hey, it ain't no good for you anyway, okay? It ain't no good. What's your nationality? American, so-called European.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. What race are you? What you identify?
Because they're
scared to walk off.
Like, they can show attention.